Hello there. Welcome to this video. Let's see very quickly how to use Linux starting from a very beginner level. Make sure to visit our official YouTube channel and our website to get extras, tutorials, and new fresh tips completely free. Linux is a common and free operative system that is chosen over Windows and Mac OS for server management, thanks to its deep stability against crashes, and in general for its excellent security against viruses, being every action always executed after a user approval. Linux is also open source, from which several distributions have been derived, including Ubuntu, Fedora, Red Hat, and more, chosen according to their performance, resource, distribution, or your hardware age. In this video, we will use Ubuntu version 20. To interact with Linux, you can either use its graphic interface or the most common bash terminal, such as a textual interface where to type several commands and use the enter key to get them executed. You can also open new terminals using Ctrl and Alt and T, also using multiple ones at the same time if you need. All the commands are written on the command line, showing on the left the Linux username logged in at and the computer identification. Then the current directory path follows under a different color, followed by a sign, which is a dollar in case you were working as a user, and as a hashtag if you were working as a super user or root. By default, you are at your home directory or tilde, which is your default personal directory. If you type pwd and apply with the enter key, you will get the full directory path you are on, showing the home directory. To check the content of the current directory, use ls. All the subdirectories are shown in a bold blue color, whereas all files are shown in white. These colors can change depending on the Linux version you use. You can use ls-l to get more information, including file permissions, the author name and group, the size in bytes, and the last modification date. This username and group name, here with the same name, are useful to manage the permissions on each item, as shown on the extreme left. The first character specifies if the current item is a directory, showing a D or a file, showing a minus sign. The following letters are read taking groups of three characters. The first one sets the author permissions, the second one the group permissions, and the third one any external user outside the specified group. The granted permissions are shown as R for reading, W for editing, and X for execution. In this case, the text TXT file can be read by anyone, but it can be modified just by the specified username or group name. To change these permissions, you can type chmod followed by options and file name interested. For example, the u-x option removes the execute x permission from the author user u. Whereas with u plus wx, you will add editing and execute permissions to the author u. You can also use G or O instead of U to manage permissions for groups and external users respectively. Consider that the chmod command works only in case you are the original author of the file or the administrator. Other users can't change permissions. You can use cd to enter into directories, specifying the directory name. Use the tab key to auto-complete the name. You can also use cd... to return to the previous level. The double dot sign always indicates the upper level in the directory path. whereas cd dot does not perform any action since the single dot represents the current directory path you are on. To create a new directory type, mkdir, and the name of the new directory, that will be completely empty. Whereas, use touch plus name to create a new empty file. All these files are intended as textual files, which are the most used ones on Linux. We won't see any other kinds of files in this beginner tutorial. By specifying the file or directory name after the command, you always intend the current directory you are on. You can also type an entire directory path to place or pick any item placed in such subdirectory. This works with the touch mkdir commands and for any other we will see. Use mv to move files into any folder or directory path without changing its content. Type the file name and the destination path using ./ or no characters to start from the current directory. In this case, the new file is no more present in the current folder, but inside the subfolder. You can also specify a new name after the destination path to rename the file as you move it. Whereas, use cp to make copies of any file, typing the file name and its destination path. In respect to mv, this keeps the original file as well. To copy an entire folder with all its content inside, use cp-r. For example, cp-r green white copies the green folder and its content into the white folder, keeping the original green folder where it is. To remove any file, use rm with the file name. This won't work on a directory, since this has other items inside. To remove a directory, you have to type rm-r. Pay attention that the removal is permanent. With cat, you can get a quick preview of any file content without opening it in a new window. Whereas, send history to get the full list of all the commands executed so far in order. Use clear to clear the whole terminal instead. To execute any file, for example this .sh bash script, type its name and use the Enter key. These scripts group several commands in a unique file. We won't see these in this video. On Linux, you can also make shortcuts, very useful if you don't want to specify the full directory path of the file every time. If you use ln-s with the full path of the file, you create a symbolic link in a blue color. With this link, you can read, edit, and run the file by typing its symbolic name instead of its whole path. To look for any file, simply type find and the keyword to search, followed by an asterisk. This special character is often used to include any kind of character after the ones you have specified. Now, let's see how to edit files. To open and edit these, you can either use the graphic interface or directly the bash terminal with the most common vi command. When sending vi and the file name, the terminal shows its entire textual content, indicating all the empty lines with tilde characters. To start editing, use the I key to enter into insert mode, typing and interacting with the text content, moving with your up and down arrow keys. Use the escape key to come back to the command mode in order to interact with text with several keyboard commands. For example, you can use YY to copy the entire current line, and if you place your cursor on another line and use P, you also paste the entire line that you have copied. Use the U key to undo if you need. You can also type /, plus any keyword to search through the document, starting from the beginning. Use ?? To search from the end of it. To save, use ?W. To exit from the file, type ?Q. Now, let's see how to check your current status on Linux. The df command shows the current status of all your disks, such as used and available kilobytes and used percentage. Use df-h to check all in an easier way. Whereas PS AUX shows all the applications in progress launched by the users and the super user root. In addition, you can easily install and update your system from trustful resources with the Aptitude tool. By default, this is not installed yet, so you will have to run apt-get install followed by Aptitude. All installations and upgrades on Linux can be performed by the root user only, so you may need to log in as administrator by using the sudo command followed by its password. Once the Aptitude tool is installed, you can simply use sudo aptitude upgrade to upgrade your existing packages, and aptitude install to install new ones, typing the package name. If you receive prompts, use Y to apply and N to deny. Whereas, use aptitude search with keywords to search through the full list of Linux packages, showing an I letter in case the package is installed already. This is all you need to start with Linux. Remember to launch MAN plus any command name to get tips on all the possible operations you can make with such command, using U to exit. Alternatively, you can use the command name followed by --help. Thank you for watching this video. Please leave any comment or feedback to improve our next tutorials dedicated to Linux.